everyone. We're not teaching right now, but we're in between classes and we're here in the kitchen doing developmental recipes, work, and research. And what I'm working on is something that's kind of near and dear to my heart and also to geography. Because right here in Spain, there's a classic dish called the tortilla de patata. Which is not a tortilla that we know in North America. There's no wheat, you don't roll it up and make a burrito. It actually has egg always in it. And we've been challenged by many people to say, you can never make that vegan. You have to use eggs. And guess what? We're not using garbanzo flour, we're not using tofu. We're using one of our products that I'll show you a little later, how you can easily, in 4 ingredients, recreate this Spanish classic. First off, you need to get your own family recipe. Every single family has their own version of this special, fantastic tortilla. So we don't have one, we're not gonna give it to you.
You're not gonna give them a recipe?
No, you're not gonna get a recipe. You need to come up with your own. The basic ingredients were egg and potato, onion, and oil. That's it. So you need to come up with your ratios and how you do it. We're gonna show you our version. So here, I'm not cooking on the stove. I do need to cook this stuff, but actually I have a pressure cooker.
Why are you using a pressure cooker?
Because...
What do you gotta go something, or what, why?
Yeah, I wanna go. I'm gonna make this, set it, and forget it.
Set it and forget it.
That's right.
So you can use any sort of pressure cooker.
Absolutely.
You can also use a pan on a stove if you want.
You can use a pan on a stove, you can use a pressure cooker. I'm just gonna put a bunch of oil in here. This is just a basic.
Why do you put a bunch of oil?
Because the classic recipe has, if you think you have enough oil, you don't. You have enough and then add some more. They use a ton of oil in this recipe. I'm not separating my onions from my potatoes. They are all cut in small bite-sized pieces and they're going straight in and they're gonna get fried up. Kind of pre-fried, like parboiled.
So you just, what do you do with this? You stir it all the time or do you have to go to yoga?
No, I have to go to yoga soon. So I'm just gonna lightly fry these and I'm gonna show you the next step and then we're gonna forget it. For those of you who are making it with your own recipe, the trick that you can tell other people is that you are using a special type of egg. That's your family's twist. For our eggs, you take 1 packet of our omelet mix and you add it to 500 mils of water. With a little splash of any mild oil, whiz it up in a blender, pour it in a container, and you'll be ready right away. So it's not the veg or some vegan egg. Come up with a name, a real name, like Gloria or Philomena. And that way you too can have a name for your fantastic vegan twist Spanish tortilla. So this egg has how much cholesterol? Zero. How much salmonella? Zero. How many growth hormones were put into this egg? Zero. And is this gonna raise your blood pressure? No. Is this gonna give you type 2 diabetes? No.
What about the cost?
Cost? This is equal or less expensive than free-range, organic, or any other eggs that you're gonna find throughout the world.
But what about protein? Because eggs have so much protein.
Eggs do have a lot of protein, but believe it or not, this has more. That's right. Believe it or not, more protein can be found in a potato, yes, a vegetable, because they just pull out the protein from the potato. There is, in almost every food, protein. And out of the potatoes, millions of potatoes, they pull out the protein and we put it in there.
How does it compare on the amino acid profile to eggs?
It stack ranks super duper well against eggs in the amino acid profile. In fact, You get almost every single amino acid from this.
So bodybuilders could eat this too, right?
Absolutely. Bodybuilders could crank on this. You could do so many more reps. You will be shocked at how much more energy you'll have, how much better you'll sleep, how you'll recover faster from workouts. Your muscles will love you, and so will your doctor.
But what else does this egg have? Does it have anything like... Does it have anything that's better for you, like protein and stuff?
Well, yeah, absolutely. In addition to the protein, it also has fiber. Because guess how much fiber is in eggs? Zero. But there's a ton of fiber in here, as well as we talked about those amino acids.
So how do you know if it's cooked enough?
Well, it's your recipe. You figure it out.
So is there like a right amount? We don't want them raw, right?
They have to cook. No, you don't want to break a tooth and go to the dentist. But you don't want them overcooked because you're going to be setting it and forgetting it. It's time now to pour in our Philomena.
Or is it Gloria?
Or Gloria. I'm not doing anything here except putting in a teeny weeny weeny bit more oil. Because like I said, you can never have enough, but it's your recipe. And now, I'm pouring in. Here's the most important part, and a unique twist. We're not cooking the egg anymore. We're removing the power source. We're turning it completely off. Pull it out. That's the way I remember. You just want to close it, set it, and forget it. So you do want to cover it and allow it to sit for about 30 minutes. Years from now. So now after it's cool, just take the top off. Look at that. We're gonna pop it off or invert it onto a serving plate of your choice. And then you can do a taste test. I heard it. Voila. And now for plating. Typically, a wedge is cut and served just like you would cut almost like a pie. Now, here in Spain, there's something we have called patatas bravas. That means potatoes bravas. And what I love to put on my tortilla is brava sauce. Bam. But the interesting part is that this dish is normally made with egg, but here we actually have potatoes inside because we use protein. Mmm. Buenísimo. So how do you make this at home? Super easy and super low cost. Just grab one of our omelet mixes off our website. We'll put the link below and you too can make this super delicious tortilla de patata. And guess who's going to be the happiest other than your stomach? Gloria, the super duper happy chicken. Go online and check out the story of her and see why she is a big proponent of the vegan egg.